The idea of seeing a robot like interact with the world, there's not a person controlling it, yet it's doing all these things. That is the most exciting type of intelligence. I'm a PhD student at Georgia Tech. I work on problems at the intersection of computer vision and robotics, answering the question, how can humans teach robots how to do things by using data that has been captured from an egocentric perspective?
We are trying to use what we call human data. We capture how humans interact with the world, and that data gets used to train a robot. We can actually capture this kind of data with Aria glasses.
It really checked the boxes, which is it's recording a front-facing RGB image, it's tracking your hands in 3D space, and it's localizing the glasses.
It actually captures the environment, builds a map, and knows precisely where the glass is at any given moment.
We have tried to make this an out-of-the-box solution. That means you can put them on, pair your glasses with the companion app, and start recording data right away without writing any code. We look at Aria as an investment in the research community. What personally motivates me is to see the creativity of how these researchers are solving problems.
Oh, it's stuck, it's stuck. Let the people feel the pain of roboticists. Yeah.
Research partners give us feedback, and we can turn around new features pretty quickly. The most surprising thing was to see Aria mounted on a robot, but I think it was quite genius.
Robotics is a real-time problem. Real-time recognition of behaviors and the surrounding environment is fundamental to robotics. Aria is such a small form factor, we can just put it on the robot and have it directly control its own body by looking at the world through Aria glasses.
Georgia Tech made use of the Aria Client SDK, which allows them to directly stream data from the Aria glasses to a machine that can then do inference with a trained model directly from the sensor stream.
This system is a really natural way to collect data that is useful for robotics. I think a lot of people were really excited about this because the promise of scale is much higher than anything else.
The more that the egocentric research community standardizes, the more researchers will be able to collaborate. It's really through scaling with the community like this, collectively, we can start to solve bigger problems around how things are going to work in the future.
When more people can collect this kind of data without conscious effort, we can cover a broad range of scenarios and tasks. That type of diversity at such a rich sensor level is a dream come true.